What about London? I mean, London seems. I've been living abroad for 20 odd years, so.
Right.
Yeah. It's a hell of a lot faster, more crowded, more of everything.
Well, yeah, that's the UK in general, isn't it? It's very overcrowded. Far too many. There's so much going on in London, isn't there? You know, I mean, New York isn't as busy as London when it comes to gigs. You know, you can be in New York and you're not in London. How many are there a night? 300 gigs a night, whatever. So much going on, you know, and the fact that people hear about things so quickly. So, yeah, it's overcrowded. I would agree with that. I know it's oversaturated, but which makes it very hard for venues to always stay busy, to be honest. I think the bigger the venues, that's different. If you're running Brixton Academy or whatever, you're the only 5,000 cap venue, really, so you're going to stay busy or whatever. But in this level of the market, I think it's really competitive. And people are quite scared in doing mid-sized venues. They'd rather be cautious and do 200 or 300 caps, sell it out, then move up. They'd rather be doing that than be trying to reach that 500 where they don't know. It's
an awkward number, isn't it?
It never used to be, but it is now, I think. I mean, that doesn't mean, as I say, we have plenty of good shows, but like all London venues, we have really busy periods and then really quiet periods.
Yeah.
You know? And they'll all be the same. I mean, maybe the Jazz Cafe or something in Camden probably stay busier than us because they book in house and it's slightly different. We don't book a lot of in house shows. So.
Yeah.
But generally, yeah.
And you said you're working with a promotion company, etc.
Well, I run this as well as, I mean, I run the diary here mainly.
Yeah.
And have done for like quite a few years now. But I also am an independent promoter.
Wow.
So I put on shows around London and other shows around the UK. And I'm also part of a company, it's called Communion, which is I helped start this, the live side of this company, even though I'm just a consultant for it now.
Yeah.
But they're promoting stuff like James May and George Ezra and Ben Howell and that type of stuff. Mm-hmm. It's more of a current, company, but so I do like three different jobs basically.
Goodness grief. But that's also part of London now, isn't it? That's what I mean. It's like everything, because it's so busy, now you have to do so much anyway just to survive. But
it's probably a part of life these days, you know. I mean, you often have to do two or three things. But I mean, it's sort of, for me, it's something I've stayed here a long time, excuse me, because I quite like the contact. I like the venue, and I actually like the fact that working with the other promoters all the time is just a good contact.
Yeah.
You know, it keeps you talking to people, you hear what's going on. So it's a good job to have, even if you're doing your own thing, you know what I mean? Because it's just a side, it's not a side job, but it's a good to see the bands coming through here, and it's just good, it's, even though I probably shouldn't be doing it now, because I'm too damn old.
Keeps you plugged in.
It's still good to do, you know? Yeah. But I'm running a festival myself in the autumn, which is like a London Folk and Roots Festival.
Right.
Different venues around London, like about 20 shows in different sort of spaces, some big, some small, with the idea of trying to help new artists as well as established artists. So
you're kind of a Mother Teresa as well.
There you go, you see. I wouldn't say so, but I mean, all the things try and be more involved with helping new artists and helping them move forward and seeing new talent. Because there's not enough of that. The food is too greedy now. I don't really care. You know, I mean, it's just.
Well, I like your honesty.
Well, there you go. Probably won't help me.
No, honesty does. I think it helps more than people really understand.
Could be.
Yeah.
Could be. The music industry has always been a moving item, isn't it? Yeah. Any creative job's a moving item. I'm sure if you work in TV or whatever, it changes all the time. And it should do, because it's a creative item, isn't it? So.
Yeah.
It's not going to stand still.
That means that once it stands still, it's a dead thing.
Exactly.
It's a dead thing.
Exactly. So it's interesting, but I personally think it's nice that things move along. So,
Of course.
It makes it difficult, but hey, it's life.
But it's not that difficult for you. You've got your thing set up. You've got things set up quite well.
Yeah, it's slightly harder now, though. It's quite corporate now. So the bigger promotion companies, like corporates, tend to be plowing their way through the marketplace, offering a lot of money for artists just because they want it. It's just a numbers game, if you know what I mean. That's not mean they're no good at it, but they do. It's just that's how it is.
Yeah.
It's about money. You know?
So how do you counter that? What's the remedy?
I think you work in niche markets, because otherwise you wouldn't survive. I mean, the other company we work with is much more on the forefront of the contemporary market, very competitive. What I do outside of here is not quite so competitive, so I'm working with more established artists. So it's not the same fight to get those people, because they are where they are, if you know what I mean. So I might do a show at the Union Chapel, say, that's going to sell 900 tickets, which is a decent show to do, but then somebody might, oh, well, that artist is going to get bigger, so they get. And that's probably a little bit what goes on. You know? So obviously we call people, all promoters really want is an artist that's going to grow to arena size and make the money, which is fair enough.
Yeah.
So it works. You know, so
it's business.
It's business, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
It's nothing personal.
It's nothing personal, exactly. It's nothing personal. A lot of people think it is, but it's not, is it?
No.
It's just about what money it makes. You know? I mean, this venue's, better say, this venue's a good, strong venue. You know?
It's been around a very long time.
Probably one of the longest of its size in London, you know, I mean, outside of like 100 Club,
yeah,
places like that. Martin, which is sadly gone now, and, you know. Yeah. So venues don't always, I don't think this will be here in a few years, they're going to refurbish this.
They're upgrading the area, aren't they?
They're going to redevelop it, it'll happen, probably beyond from IKEA, but yeah. Next 5-10 years, probably even the next five. It doesn't mean this won't be here, it might end up being part of a new complex,
yeah.
It might end up being somewhere across the other side of the canal, who knows. But you can't stop that either, can you?
No, they're upgrading the area.
I mean, this is not the original space as it was in the Dingwalls Go. I mean, back in about 1990 it changed.
Mm.
So the old Dingwalls changed then anyway. So you could argue it's not the original building. Just has, I mean, the building itself is, but this actual space is slightly different.
Yeah.
So it'll just become, it could become something different.
And you want to be around still doing what you're doing, or?
Probably not. I should probably be lying in the sun somewhere, I don't know, who knows.
Jamaica or something?
Yeah, very possibly. Barbados? Yeah, very possibly, yeah. The beach up. Picking up seashells. I probably won't do this job for more than, I don't know, 4 or 5 more years maybe.
Yeah.
Who knows. Yeah. At the moment, I tend to, for my own career, I'm working on projects rather than trying to be that competitive promoter, if you know what I mean.
Because
it's more of a younger person's thing anyway.
Yeah, it's, I mean, and it's fierce.
The people I work with in the other company, they're in their 20s. You know?
Yeah.
And I think you see music and hear music in a different way when you're younger. So you tend to have different ears.
Yeah.
You know? So it's like, I mean, it doesn't mean we can't hear good music, but we don't pick up on it in the same way, you know what I mean? Not quite as fast, perhaps.
I think it depends if your heart's in it.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I still, interestingly enough, I love the other company, it's very creative. So it's like, you know, I like the creative side of things, if you know what I mean. So it's nice to hear new stuff coming through if it's good.
Right.
And these guys have really good ears for good talent. So
So you can back that, what you can do is you can confirm that with your experience as well.
That's basically what happens. Right. See, they pick up talent, they use my experience of promoting for years, made the company what it was.
Right.
What it is. So, yeah, interesting.